manager, Father John Dewey, school administrator, Father Solomon, pre-primary headmistress, Sister Kanta, office staff, teachers, and my dear students. I welcome you all in the reopening prayer service. Soma Chotir Gamaya. Let the light keep away all the darkness around the world. Let the light bring knowledge and wisdom. Let us begin this prayer session by lighting the lamp.
Our Father in heaven,
holy be your name,
your kingdom come,
your will be done on earth,
as in heaven.
Give us this day,
our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins.
As we forgive those who sin against us.
Do not bring us to the test.
But deliver us from evil.
Amen.
Thought for the day by Vidya Ma'am.
Good morning, everyone. The founder of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales Congregation, Father Peter Mary Mermier, said, and I quote, "The heart of education is the education of the heart." It means the highest form of education that one could have is the one where the heart is placed before anything else. No matter how smart you are, if you do not put your heart in everything you do, it would mean nothing. Thank you.
Now, I request our administrator, Father Solomon, to please come forward to deliver a short message. Father Arun, dear Father John Dewey, the manager, Sister Kanda, the headmistress, dear teachers, parents, and students, a warm good morning to you all. I am indeed glad to address you all and give you a short message, especially during this COVID-19 pandemic. During this pandemic, we are supposed to be at home, but at the same time, we did not remain idle. On the contrary, teachers, parents, and students kept themselves active through online classes. Very often in our life, as the saying goes, cry over spilt milk. What does it mean? It simply means thinking or spending too much time on the bad experiences or bad situations that come our way. For example, at this moment, all the people all over the world are facing inconvenience due to the COVID-19 pandemic. This pandemic itself is taking away our peace of mind and social aspect of our human life. So in this situation, too much thinking about the pandemic is like crying over spilled milk. At the same time, I would not say do not bother at all about this pandemic. But too much worrying is not needed and it will not bring about a change. But how can we channel this bad experience into a positive situation for ourselves? I already mentioned, through our online classes, our Francilian School of Excellence family was active and continued to be active. These online classes are going through the initiative of the management and the staff. But let us not restrict ourselves to online classes alone, but rather each one individually must get involved in something good. For example, developing reading habit. And I can guarantee you all today that you will never regret of developing this habit or consider this as waste of time. Reading habit surely will enhance your knowledge as well as is the best free time hobby, I would say. A few other examples I could think of is like developing your drawing abilities, singing ability, dancing ability, gardening, those who have a place for gardening, writing poem, or many other activities you can get involved yourselves. And nobody has become famous in a fortnight. People have tasted failure and hardship, but with determination, they all attained success. God has given us all talent, and nobody is without any talent. So let us make use of this COVID-19 pandemic situation positively and benefit ourselves and at the same time Be considerate to one another. Let us not cry over spilt milk. And I take this opportunity, dear students, as you have already begun your exams, all the best and do well. And at the same time, I wish all the teachers as well, as you will be involved conducting this exam, all the best and do well. Have a nice day. Thank you. Thank you, Father. When you pray for others, God listens to you and blesses them. Today, we are also praying for our near and dear ones. And your response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all the members of FSC management. O Lord, we place all these members in your hands. Holding their hands, O Lord our God, guide them at their each step and every decision they make. Lord, not us, but let your will be done on earth. For this we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for our principal, Father Arun Paulus. Gracious and loving God, thank you for the gift of our priest. Through them we experience your presence. Help our Father Principal to be strong and set his soul on fire with love for our people. Grant him the wisdom, understanding and strength he needs to follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Help him remember the greatness of work assigned to him by you. Help him to become instrument of your divine grace. For this we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the school. Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us together to understand and acquire wisdom and knowledge. Make our school, school of excellence and temple of wisdom. Send your spirit upon us and make us your messengers of truth and love. Shower your blessings throughout the year upon our school, authorities, teachers and students. For this we pray.
For staff members and peers, Almighty and loving God, guide and inspire our staff members to work diligently for the betterment of the students who are entrusted to their care. May they always keep in mind their duty of building the future of each and every student. May the teachers and educators warn their students and pupils respectively about the dangers of social media and other instruments of social communication used unguarded. Bless our pupils who are equally part of the service towards the school and the students, that they may work with dedication and sincerity. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students, Heavenly Father, please be with these students. May they remain focused and calm, confident in their facts and abilities, and may they grow in faith and wisdom. Grant that they may devote themselves towards study and draw ever closer to you, the source of all knowledge. May they face each day with positivity and conquer their fears. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
your commandment that we should honor our father and mother. Hear the prayer we offer for them. Grant them many years on earth and keep them safe in health of mind and body. Bless their work and all they do. Give them back 100-fold for whatever they have done for us. Inspire them to fulfill your holy law so that one day may we bear their comfort and support. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prayer for the leaders. O Lord, I thank you for who you are. Lord, your words remind us that you are our strength, you are our energy, you are our life, and we can do all things through you, not by ourselves alone. We can pray that every leader may lean on you, praise. They understand and see things better, and do build just human society. May your leadership guide and enable every leader to be a leader for the service of the humanity, where every person on the earth feels the experience of love, justice, liberty, liberty of thought, expression, and fraternity. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the control of the spread of COVID-19 pandemic. O Lord, the frightful claws of coronavirus have trapped the world from all sides. At that time, we are extremely frightful. In the world, the patients of coronavirus are increasing by day and night. We all are fearful about it. With this unexpected fright, unknown difficulty, and inauspicious news, we are scared and losing our calm. We are caught up in the storm of restlessness. Please have mercy and grant us the strength to fight against all this. With your grace, may the fear that is spreading all over subside, and may the world once again become peaceful, safe, and healthy. This is the plea at your feet, Lord. For this we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the country. O God, we ask your blessing on our beautiful country with peace, prosperity, protection, and development. Thank you for the freedom we enjoy. Thank you for the diversity of our people and enlarge our capacity for tolerance and mutual respect to each other. O God, keep our country always in unity, in diversity. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace in the world. Let us pray for the peace in the whole world. Let the leaders of all nations, both great and small, may govern the people selfishly and tirelessly. That they may use all their power to establish peace in the world, negotiation and dialogues, let the chosen representatives bring about development, that followers of different faiths may live in peace and harmony. For this we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Since we are beginning our pre-midterm exam from 9th of July, a special prayer for our students. O Lord, we have come to your feet, seeking your grace. Give us a heart of wisdom. Give our students strength and guard them so that no sickness or weakness would attack them until the exams are over. Be with them while writing the exam and bring to their remembrance all that they have learned. Give them the grace to write the correct answers for each question within the stipulated time. With clear, firm, and a focused mind, without any fear and anxiety. Thank you, dear God. Amen.
now, I call them for pledge, followed by preamble by Captain Man.
Kindly stretch your right hand forward and repeat after me. India is my country.
India is my country.
All Indians are.
All Indians are.
My brothers and sisters.
My brothers and sisters.
I love my country.
I love my country.
And I am proud.
And I am proud.
Of its rich.
Of its rich.
And very heritage.
And very heritage.
I shall always strive.
I shall always strive.
To be worthy of it.
To be worthy of it.
I shall give my parents.
I shall give my parents.
Teachers,
and all elders,
respect,
and treat everyone
with courtesy. To my country,
and
my people,
I pledge my devotion
in their well-being,
and
prosperity alone
lies
my
happiness.
Please hang strong.
Kindly take the preamble position. We, the people of India,
having solemnly resolved
to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular,
democratic republic,
and to secure to all its citizens
justice,
social,
economic,
and political,
liberty of thought, expression,
belief,
faith, and worship,
equality of status,
and of opportunity,
and to promote among them all
fraternity.
Assuring the dignity of the individual,
and the unity,
and the integrity of the nation.
In our Constituent Assembly,
this 26th day of November 1949,
do hereby adopt,
enact,
and give to ourselves
this constitution.
Hands down.
A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. Now, I call upon our principal, follow word of wisdom.
Dear students, parents, teachers, the last 2 years, our school, we used to begin the beginning of June or 10th or 15th of June. However, this June was not the same. When we used to begin the school, we used to come to the school with a full of life, with a full of vigor and energy to meet our friends and the teachers to start a fresh new academic year. This year, due to COVID-19, we are all locked down. We are all confined within four walls of our house, but we as teachers are not locked down. In the wake up of COVID-19, Francilin School of Excellence joined the Maharashtra government and the nation the fight against the spread of COVID-19 by donating to the Maharashtra Chief Minister's Fund and Prime Minister's Care Fund, and also distributing ration to the poor, the needy and the hungry, and to the local people. This unfamiliar situation had made us to have virtual reopening of the school on 2nd May 2020 onwards. Today, some of us are gathered here at the school to pray and sing blessings upon our dear students, parents, doctors, nurses, police personnel, leaders, teachers, school management, and all of us. We pray to God that we are able to tread this unfamiliar learning with a great success. Dear students, you are used to learn and study in a convenient and airy academic classroom. But today, you are learning from a handset or a laptop. Your teachers are physically present, but wisdom comes to you online. Dear students, the teachers are making extra effort to keep going the education. Your teachers are not missing a single minute to give you value education. Dear students, this kind of learning, this kind of unfamiliar learning is like going to war or to battle. War with whom? With opponent. Who is our opponent? The opponent is the handset or the laptop. Because you are asked to stand or sit in front of this handset and laptop for hours long. When you are able to equip and tune yourself to sit in front of this handset and the laptop, you'll be able to master yourself or war yourself against impatience and intolerance. Thus, you cultivate the habit of patience and the tolerance. When you are equipped and mastered yourself to be patient and tolerant, you know the values of life, the laws of life, that you need to listen, you need to observe, you need to pay attention, and you need to take decisive action that work in your favor. Dear students, do not give up. Do not run away from challenges. The teachers are making lots of effort to give you the good education. I request each of you to cooperate with our teachers, do the homework and the assignments, and be a smart online learning student. Dear parents, you are a blessed parent. You are blessed with God's gift. God has given you the blessed children. God has chosen you to be their parents. It is not you who have chosen to be their parents. It is God who has chosen you to be their parents, to nurture and care for them. Yes, my dear parents, let us thank the Lord for blessing you with good children. I, on behalf of the management and the staff, thank you for your wholehearted support and active participation in the online PTM. Dear parents, I thank you for motivating and encouraging the kids to participate and attend the online classes and all the activities of the school. Dear parents, I thank you for your appreciation and encouragement and motivation that you render to our teachers. Dear parents, I thank you for understanding the limitations we as teachers have with regard to the technology. Dear parents, for your information, very soon the school will be using Google Classroom, where all the assignments, homework, class test, exam, everything will be done as per the Google Classroom. And you'll be updated very soon once it is launched in the school. Dear parents, do not be panicked. Do not be worried. Do not be anxious. If your child is not attending the classes, because you will be going through and experiencing behavioral changes and issues of your kids. This is normally expected under these circumstances. What do they need today is more love and care. What do they need today is you need to make the children feeling comfort. Therefore, my dear parents, I request each of you to give your love and care to the kids. My dear teachers, this year is going to be most challenging academic year. It is a test of life. It is a test of ability and capacity and capability and openness to learn and equip oneself with the demanding technology. Dear teachers, you are physically present. You also experience, when you are teaching, sometimes lonely and isolated. Today I need to acknowledge the great contribution that you made towards the development of each and every child. The tireless effort, efficiently handling all the situations and arranging number of activities and programs with minute care. I need to appreciate that. Dear teachers, as you are in the COVID-19 situation, facing an unfamiliar situation where you are put into challenges to learn what you never learned, the technology, to be true guide, online guide, and desire to learn more and more the technology, and teach the students through that medium. I wish each and every one of you that you continue to learn more and more and teach properly our students. My dear students, parents, teachers, this year we have just completed 2 years of establishment. We have just celebrated 2 years of our school's existence. But much more than that, this year we need your support, your wishes and prayer. My dear students, parents and teachers, with the education at crossroads, we, the Francilian School of Excellence teachers and managers, are the forefront to revamp the education, the changing realities. My dear students, we want everyone to live happily. We want everyone to help each other. We want to nurture and train the young minds to think differently. We want to educate the young minds not what to think but how to think. Because every day is a new day with a new opportunity to be better and become better. We need to ask when we get up out from the bed, can you do better? What can you do better? What are the solutions and what are the steps you can take to be better and function at your highest level? My dear students, parents, teachers, in whatever field we are, we need to ask ourselves before we go to bed, what have I done? Did I do something better? Did I function at the highest level? With this note, I wish our children, as they are beginning their exam, pre-midterm exam today, God bless you, wish you all the best, have a good day.
Thank you, Father. I would like to call Deepika ma'am for word of thanks.
Good morning to our principal, Father Arun, manager, Reverend Father John Dibe, administrator, Reverend Father Solomon, headmistress, Sister Kanta, and my dear teachers. I deem it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks. It is our belief that without God, we cannot take a step ahead. So I would like to thank Almighty God, our Lord, for being with us and showering His blessings upon us. It is truly said that without a good director, we cannot achieve the goal and reach our destination. I would like to thank our principal, Father Arun, for being a guide and mentor to all of us and to the institution. Thanks a lot, Father. And may Almighty God bless your journey. I would like to thank Reverend Father Solomon, Reverend Father John Dibe, Sister Kanta for being a part of this prayer service and gracing us with blessings and with your presence. I also thank all our Francilian staff who always work as a team, and this is the main reason of our great success. I wish and pray that all of us remain safe and be protected. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Kindly get ready for school anthem, followed by national anthem.
Excellent, and never be.
Thank you all. Have a good day and God bless you.